What is happening, Roll Easy fam? God, I missed you guys, man. It's only been like, honestly, I don't know, maybe like a day or so since I've posted, kind of, but feels like a week already. But anyways, I'm back, guys, with the Sultan RS dupe glitch. It is not dead. I know I've put hotfix on all of them. And by the way, guys, if you guys don't know what hotfix is just a minor patch. It's not a full patch. What a hotfix means is that they just patched a certain little part of the glitch, but the glitch can still work. We just have to find another way. When you see patch, that means that everything, the whole glitch is done. You know, we're not going to find another workaround. All right, but I do got another workaround for you. So make sure to like the video, comment, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. You know I'm bringing you the freshest and most fucking informative dope content out there, guys. I'm always bringing you guys the workaround to make more money. Got some more stuff in the works. So for this one, I'm going to show you guys a dupe glitch where you guys need the custom plate. This one you need the custom plates for. Same thing as always, you need the MOC with the personal vehicle storage, a Sultan RS, Sultan RS or the Donk, that car that goes on 24s also works, I believe, so you can use that as well. And so you want custom plates on this one. You need custom plates for this first glitch. I'm going to show you a glitch after this where you don't need custom plates. And you just want any garage filled with Faggios or RH8 so you guys can dupe the whole garage and everything. And you're going to see why. You know, throw yourself in an invite-only session. And your MOC actually doesn't even have to be on that flat of a surface. Just decently flat. You don't even have to get the animation. I actually prove it in this video that you don't need the animation every time. I've actually gotten to hit the glitch right here without the animation of the car going inside. And I did it right here in front of Del Perro. And I got to give a quick shout-out to the new workaround founders. They are Lost Glitches and Freight Train What the Fudge. If you want to put it on a flat surface to get the animation, it might work better. Now, guys, this is tricky. If you're on Xbox, this is easy. You know, you're gonna, all you got to do, make sure you have your controller plugged in with a cord. And to get the alert, we're actually going to be yanking out the cord as we're pressing the gas. Sounds crazy, I know. But for PlayStation, if you got the old controllers, it's a little bit tricky. If you have the new PS4 Pro controllers that came out recently, you're good. You know, you can actually use this method as well by just, I do believe you can yank the cord out. I don't know if, you guys can yank the cord out if you guys put it to, you guys have to change the setting to USB only to be able to yank the cord out, and you can do this glitch. But if you guys have the old PS4 controllers, which is probably most of you, there's a little reset button. It's in a tiny little hole on the back of your controller. You guys need a paper clip, and what you're going to be doing is standing behind the car. I'll explain it thoroughly a little bit into the glitch, but you're going to be standing behind the car. And you're gonna press Y and then right trigger and then go ahead and use the paperclip to reset your controller, because it takes about 5 to 6 seconds from what I've heard. And when you actually press reset, you might not have controls anymore, but you press triangle and R2 already. So your guy is actually going to go over there and he's going to do the action. And right as that alert hits, then you're going to be able to actually get glitched out. Now, let me just show you right here what it's like. And I'll explain that the PS4 controller method. So I'm on Xbox, so this is a bit easier for me. I'm hooked up with a cord to my controller. So this is what I'm doing. All I got to do is hop into my car right here with the Sultan RS. Now the engine starts. I'm gonna hit right trigger and literally pull out the cord right away. And you see that? Please reconnect the controller. That's all you gotta do to get glitched out. You should end up outside now, on the ground with no car, and you know, that's you want to make sure there's no car on the map at all. If it's under the MOC, it's not going to work. If it's at the docks, it's not going to work. If you go inside and it disappears, it's not going to work. Remember, use your interaction menu with the MC president to return to storage and your car will come back. If you don't have that option, call up a motorcycle to return it and then go back in your MOC and the car will be there. All right. So as you can see, we got the stacked cars. Now I'm going to show you guys what to do once you get the stacked cars. And this method, you need custom plates for, and you need about $1 million. Okay, but first I'm gonna go ahead and call up one of my Faggios. Now I said Faggios because we can call them right through the MC menu. So you just gotta call it up right there. It's out on the street, that's all you need. Go ahead and open up your internet, and you're gonna go ahead and go to the Warstock menu and renovate your MOC. So go to Bay 2 and you're gonna purchase the Weapon and Vehicle Workshop. It's gonna cost you 955 grand. Go ahead and buy it. And now just wait for it to let you go into the MOC. Remember, we have a Faggio already out here, ready to be duped. Okay, the Faggio is gonna be a dupe, not when you come outside, but it's actually gonna be stored wherever you got the Faggio from. Okay, so keep that in mind. Now once you hop into the MOC, you know, the car might look fucked up, the door might be open, you're good. You see, you got a glitch car inside the vehicle workshop, so go ahead and press right D-pad to enter to modify the vehicle. You're gonna go to plates, and you're gonna go ahead and change the color and change the plate as well. I recommend having multiple plates, and go ahead and exit vehicle. Do not exit MOC. You will ruin the glitch, and you'll stop it, and you have to get re-glitched. Now, you guys that have been watching my videos have seen this glitch a million times. I know this is for the newer subscribers, but also if you haven't, oh yeah, and you see I returned a vehicle to storage. That's it. I returned the Faggio. That's a dupe. So I'm calling up another Faggio and I'm getting ready to dupe again. So you guys have seen this before, but for you new subscribers that haven't, which since I've been gone, I saw we got a bunch of new subscribers. I need to show this for them. And if you don't have a PS4, a more modern PS4 controller, stay tuned because I will go over it again. So once again, I'm going to change the plate color, the plate itself, exit vehicle, go outside, and I'm going to just return that Faggio to storage. And there you go. That's another dupe made. So you're just going to do that. I'm going to do it two more times, but in fast motion. Now, remember, if you have an old PS4 controller, this is what you got to do. Have a paperclip ready. You're going to be pressing inside of that reset button. Stand behind your car. Now, when you're standing behind your car, you're just going to press triangle and then R2 and go ahead and reset the controller. Now, what that's going to do, it's going to make your guy walk back, you know, to the car to actually get in the car, get the car started, and it'll actually press right trigger. It'll press the gas, although you have no control over it. It will press the gas, okay? And you have to play with the timing. You might have to stand backwards. You might have to, you know, maybe have the car door open. It depends on what timing you have with the alert, so it's a little bit trickier for you PlayStation users. But as you can see, I fast forwarded and I got 4 dupes already. That was obviously, I fast forwarded the last 2, but it's still really quick. You know, you pay $1 million once and that's it. You can make your dupes, okay? So if you're on Xbox, very easy. If you are if you do have the more modern PS4 Pro controllers that came out recently, you can also do this as well. You have to change your settings to USB only, and you'll be able to do this as well. You just got to press right trigger and yank your control or your cable at the same time to get the alert, and you end up outside. That's all you got to do. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys the one that you do need custom plates for. Now, obviously, I have a custom plate on, or sorry, that you don't need custom plates for. Now, I have a custom plate on mine, but you don't need to. You can have any regular plate. As you can see right there, I just got in the car, waited for the engine to start, yanked my cable, and pressed right trigger at the same time. So on the new PS4 controllers, you can yank your cable and press R2 at the same time. That's all you got to do, all right? And I already told you what happens if it doesn't work, but check this out. Doors open, car's glitched inside. I touch it, and look at that. The other car glitches right through. All right, starts spazzing out, going crazy and stuff. That's all you got to do. Remember, I only had 1 Faggio left in that Del Perro apartment, garage. So I'm going to end up actually calling that up right now. And guys, if you do have questions about the PS4 old controller method, I'm going to post a little bit of a text tutorial, maybe not right away after this video, but I'll try to get it as soon as possible. But if you do have questions, you know, you can go ahead and write them in the comments. But I'm going to help you guys out a little bit more with that because it is a little bit trickier with the old PS4 controllers. So yeah, don't be afraid to ask. I'll definitely be touching on that a lot more. So now what you're going to do with this method, you're going to go ahead and drive your Faggio in there. It's going to ask you to transfer. Now, what this is doing, it's transferring your original car to where the Faggio came from. And now you got this car in here. This is a dupe and it's glitched in with the Faggio. The Faggio is actually glitched inside of it. That's what you want to see. That is good. Don't worry about that. It's an awesome looking glitch. But yeah, you want to see that. So now you're going to go ahead and open up your internet and you're going to go ahead and go to Legendary Motorsports, sort by price and order one of the Anus Elegy RH8s, and you're gonna order it into the MOC. Now look what option you have when you press MOC. You have Faggio. You're not ordering it over your Sultan. Go ahead and replace it. The Faggio is gone. That's all good. Go ahead and hop into the Sultan and watch this plate. Once you drive out, watch this plate magically change. You saw I had the Rolizi plate. Check this out. It's gonna take the plate from the Faggio. And there you go. I have a brand new clean plate on a brand new clean duplicate. You do not need custom plates for this method right here. If you do have custom plates, go ahead and do the first method, a lot easier. So now when you drive back in, I haven't showed this yet, but if you drive back in, look, the car disappears. That is all good. Don't worry, nothing crazy has happened. You just gotta wait now for the car to show up, and it will show up with the brand new plate. I was just walking around here, but while we do have this time, once again, I wanna go over how to get glitched out with the old PS4 controllers, just to verbally say it once again. Now, from what I've seen with my friends on PS4, is that what you got to do is stand behind the car, you know, the back left side where the driver's side door is. You might have to play with the timing a little bit in the position, but from what I've seen, it takes 5 to 6 seconds, sometimes even 7 seconds, to get the alert that your controller's been disconnected when you go to reset it. It's that alert right there. My controller actually by mistake got disconnected right there. I plug it back in very soon though. And yeah, so instead of just getting in the car and unplugging, you can't do that on the old controllers. So look for that little hole that has a button inside of it. That's why you need a paperclip. And you're gonna position your guy behind the car. Whether it's turned around, facing the car, facing to the right of the car, to the left, that's up to you. You have to find out what timing works best for you. Now, once you do that, you're going to go ahead and press triangle, which is going to get you to start walking towards the car, and then you're going to press right trigger. Just press it, triangle, right trigger, just like that, and then you go and you press the paperclip into the button to reset your controller. That it takes about 5 to 6 seconds, which is why you're positioning yourself over there. So it gives your guy time to walk over to the car, open up the door, get in, close it, start the car, and he actually does press the gas, all right? And that's how it works. And check it out. There's my duplicate right there. It shows up and it has a brand new clean plate on it. All right, so once again, I will be going over the PS4 old controller method more in depth with a text tutorial. Down in probably in the description or in the comments. I'll probably post it on a question. But yeah, that's all I got for you for the two money glitches. This is the new way to hit it. Much, much easier than the old way that a lot of people were having trouble with. And yeah, my name is Roll Easy. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like the video, comment, subscribe, and turn on post notifications for the freshest and most informative dope GTA 5 online content. Peace out, y'all.